Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to the Pre-Work System Engineering and Ergonomics Briefing 2021-2022. This video contains of the explanation of Work System Engineering and Ergonomics tutorial that will be explained by each department of Design System Kerja dan Ergonomi Laboratory. All of you, please pay attention and enjoy this video.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to the RSKE Praktikum and the RSKE Big Project. First of all, thank you to the assistant who have trying to organizing this activity. Good luck until the end of this semester. I hope my friends can follow well and orderly. And keep your spirit up because the output of this big project can be used for competition in other places such as PKM International Conference or National Conference. Take care of your health and condition, and my greetings to the family at your home. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Wassalatu wassalamu ala asrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. The Honorable Mrs. Atia as the Head of Work System Design and Ergonomics Laboratory. The Honorable Mr. Dwi as the Technician of Work System Design and Ergonomic Laboratory. Which I'm proud of, Laboratory Assistant of Work System Design and Ergonomics 2021-2022. First of all, I am Rifki Apriliansa as the Assistant Coordinator of the Work System Design and Ergonomics Laboratory. Would like to welcome you to the Work System Design and Ergonomics Laboratory. In this laboratory, you will take the Ergonomics and Work System Engineering course, which consists of two activities, namely practicum and big projects. When you take the practicum, I hope that you can do it well and be disciplined in order to get maximum results. Then for the big projects, I also hope that you can come up with creative ideas that you have, so that they can come up with solutions to the problems that exist within the scope of ergonomics. If you take it seriously, I'm sure this will be useful for you. My message is, if you have problems in carrying out practicums or big projects, do not hesitate to ask to the DSKE Laboratory Assistant. Last but not least, to all of the practitioners, cheers and good luck in the Ergonomics and Work System Design Engineering course. That's all from me. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Humanize yourself.
The explanation of the Work System Engineering and Ergonomics tutorial material will be explained by Research and Knowledge Department.
Okay, now I'm gonna explain about big project. The aim of the big project EWSNE is ergonomic transport safety invention for special people. In this big project, there are two subtema, and each group teaches one subtema. First is elderly. Elderly is advanced stage of life process characterized by a decrease in the body ability to adapt to environmental stress. And second is special people. According to regulation of Minister of Transportation of Republic Indonesia, special people are people who need special facilities and treatment. Now, sub-subtema. There are three sub-subtema. First is land transportation. According to Warpani, the model of land transportation consists of all forms of transportation that operate on land. Second is water transportation. According to Pritiana, sea transportation is activity or a process of transporting people and goods from one place to another place as close or far distance by sea using ship transportation facilities and port facilities function as distribution and service point. And third is air transport. According to Seitani, air transportation is any activity using aircraft to transport passenger, cargo, and or post for one or more airport trips. There are three scope of work. first is design. Student will research and analyze what technology is needed by the research place. The result can be interface like app and system. Second is product. Student will research and analyze problem and then provide recommendation and or innovation related to technology or equipment used the research site. Third is workstation. Student will research and analyze problem and then provide recommendation and or innovation related to ergonomic workstation for research site. For the design is more about making a new equipment design. The product is more of an innovation and then existing product or equipment. The workstation is more about the situation, work system, and existing work equipment. Now I'm gonna explain about term and condition of big project EWSNE. Participants of EWSNE big project are students who are taking EWSNE course in the semester where the pre-project is held. One team is consisting of 4 until 5 people with the same group members in the same practicum or EWSNE class. Each team is required to choose one of the subtema provided from the predefined major teams which will be selected during the EWSNE big project re-registration. Each team must choose one of the subtema provided from the predefined major teams which will be selected during the EWSNE big project re-registration. Each team will be choose one scope of work that is used as the focus of research. Each team is required to choose at least 2 materials in the biology course, anatomy and physiology, WMM, EWSNE, and other ergonomics material. Each team is required to conduct a survey and collect data directly at the research site in accordance with the problem taken. The processed data is real data that has been taken directly before. May not use the secondary data from any research. When conducting survey and collecting data outside the home, is it required to apply health protocol, such as wearing a mask when collecting data, maintain a minimum distance of 1 meter, bring hand sanitizer, wash hand before and after entering the research site. The output of the big project is in the form of final report, which will later be represented to rectors. The presentation will be delivered directly in front of lecturers who teach EWSNE course. Presentation media must use presentation slide, PPT, and prototype or product visualization. The team that is nominated as winner of big project EWSNE is required to work on a paper. The lectures and the format of writing the final report and paper will be regulated in the following discussion. Every artwork from all big project teams will be exhibited. Provision related to technical presentation and expo by each group will be determined in future provisions through the student Google Classroom or Instagram account of the SKE Laboratory. Each group is required to consult on the progress of the big project to the assistant supervisor of each the group with the following condition. Big project progress consultation includes the final report. The time for submitting the final report before the expo can be seen in timeline of big project EWSNE and paper submission will be arranged later. By registering as a big project participant, the student agree to the terms and conditions as well as all other regulations that have been set by the SKE lecturer and laboratory assistant. The laboratory has the right to change or add information related to the terms and conditions of big project EWSNE on the student Google Classroom or the SKE laboratory Instagram account. Each group that conducts big project research in the term in the form of product design is expected to be creative and innovative because the winner with the best artwork allows for the patent application which will be arranged at the later date. Okay, now I'm gonna explain about writing structure of Big Project EWSNE. Paper and final report must be written in the format provided and will be announced through the student Google Classroom or the SKE Laboratory Instagram account. The final report format will be adjusted in the timeline of Big Project progress and the detail of the format or template will be announced via Linktree, the SKE Laboratory Instagram account. The final report and papers are written in Indonesian for regular class and English for international program class. Characteristic, the writing work must meet the following requirement: solution, original, logical, and scientific, and systematic. Assessment criteria of Big Project EWSNE. Final report and paper consists of idea, aesthetic, writing, and conformity to the theme. Presentation consists of material readiness, material delivery, and material mastery. Prototype consists of function and visualization. This is the timeline of Big Project EWSNE.
Okay, now I'm gonna explain about the outline of EWSNE tutorial. There is usability tutorial, anthropometry hand tools design tutorial, manual material handling tutorial, and reaction time. Usability. Usability is used in evaluation process and in the design process of interface and a product by using the attributes and contained in reusability. Anthropometry and hand tools design. Study the size of dimension of the human body, the rules of making hand tools, and measuring the grip strength of human hand for the design of work area, consumer goods, work equipment, work environment, and work tools. Manual material handling is a study about finding the safest position in a lifting process that is done manually by humans, with the aim to designing a safe manual lifting system. And last is reaction time, a study that human cognitive speed visually and auditorily reacting to stimuli obtained by receptor.
The next explanation about the rules of work system engineering and ergonomics will be explained by practicum department.
Hello everyone, so I'm a representative from practicum department and I will explain of tutorial terms.
Okay, first of all, I will explain the tutorial flow. Students do a register, take a part in general briefing, make a mind map, participate in tutorial, post test via Google Classroom, report work, consult and accept reports, and finally collect reports through the Google Classroom. And next is assessment weight for tutorial. Consists of 25% practicum, 25% mid-test, 25% big project, and 25% final test, where the practicum is divided into 10% post-test, 40% report, 10% mind map, and 10% big project process. And next slide is tutorial schedule. Okay, we move to the next slide. I will explain code of conduct offline tutorial. 1. Comply with all existing regulation. 2. Participate in maintaining the tools used in the tutorial. 3. To participate in the entire session of tutorial. 4. To dress politely, clean and tidy, as well as to avoid wearing t-shirt, jacket, jumper, and hoodie. For male students are required to wear colored clothes, and for female students, it is mandatory to wear headscarf and skirt during the tutorial. 5. During the tutorial, students must bring an integrated assistant note and sheet of observation. And 6. During the tutorial, the students are not allowed to leave the session without permission. 7. Students must be responsible and maintain calm and do not interfere during the tutorial.
8, during the tutorial, the students are not allowed to eat or smoke. 9, during tutorial, the students prohibited from using cell phone or other gadgets. 10, students are required to maintain and be responsible for the equipment used in the laboratory, including the software used for the tutorials. And the students are prohibited copying software for any reason without the assistant permission. 11, students who violate the provision will be subject to sanction in accordance with the provision regulated in the SKE Laboratory Regulation. And 12, matters that have not been regulated in this regulation will be determined later. And next, we move to Code of Conduct Online Tutorial. 1. To participate in the entire session of tutorial. 2. The students are expected to study the learning videos that have been distributed before class takes place. 3. To dress politely, clean and tidy, as well as to avoid wearing t-shirt, jacket, jumper, and hoodie. During tutorial, students are required to be on cam. 5. During the tutorial, students are prohibited from leaving the classroom without permission from the assistant. 6. During tutorial, the students are not allowed to eat or smoke. 7. The tutorial permit is given to the assistant and is only valid for 7 days from not following the tutorial. 8. Students are expected to confirm with the assistant on duty or their respective assistant supervisor if they experience problems when doing the tutorial or during the tutorial. And 9. The council and SEC report submission limit is at 8 p.m. and the operating hour for the council and SEC report submission limit may change at any time according to the policy of each assistant. And next, permission for tutorial. All authorized permission as ruled by faculty by submitting the official letter to the assistant who is assigned for the designated week and maximum have plus 7, and there is a class substitution and no punishment. Second, is not accordance with the faculty rules, and there is no substitution class, and there is punishment, 30% decreasing of the report value. And next is mind map. 1. The mind map is done in the groups. 2. Create a digital mind map with the design application or platform. 3. Not allowed to make it on paper. 4. Upload it to Google Classroom according to each class maximum before the next tutorial time. Collected by one of the group's member. 5. Must write down the group's code and the name and name of the group member. 6. If there is lateness in uploading or plagiarism, mind map is 0. And the 7. The mind map's keyword must be included in the mind map. The keyword will be given every time the change of the modules. 8. The mind map is made as creative as possible regarding the tutorial material to be taught. And 9. The mind map file must be in JPG or JPEG or PNG. And next is term of tutorial. If the lateness is less than 10 minutes, you are allowed to enter the class. You still can take the post-test and the report is not reduced. 2. If the lateness is more than 10 minutes, you are allowed to enter the class but not attendance. You cannot take the post-test or your post-test is 0 and the report is not reduced. For addition to offline tutorial terms, if you do not bring integrated assistant note, you are allowed to enter the class but not attendance. You cannot take the post-test or your post-test is 0 and the report is not reduced. 4. Being late or not submitting a mind map is allowed to present and do the post-test. The report value is not reduced but the mind map value is 0. And 5. For addition to offline tutorial terms, if you do not bring observation sheet, you are allowed to enter the class but not attendance. You cannot take the post-test or your post-test is 0 and the report is not reduced. And the last is cheating on post-test. Your post-test value is 0 without announcement. Next is report. The maximum consultation is H plus 12. If you don't consult, the report value is reduced by 30%. The consultation is not required to be face-to-face meeting, but can be via email. The requirement for consultation are completing the report until the analysis part. Next is maximum ACC. For the maximum ACC, H plus 13. If you don't make ACC, the report value is reduced by 10%. ACC is not required to face-to-face meeting, but can be via email. And the ACC requirement is to complete the report until the conclusion. And the last is submission. For the submission of report in the form of subfile, maximum H plus 13 at 23:59 PM. And if you don't collect the report, value is zero, and the report will be collected by each individual. And if it's more than 23:59 PM, the report value is reduced by 30%. The report requirement to be submitted is that the report has been accredited by your assistant and submit via Google Classroom. And the last term is additional duty and fine. Maximum additional task collection when ACC report. Additional task in the form of review opening one chapter of ergonomics or review three international journal according to the tutorial theme. Not submitting additional assignment, the report score is reduced by 10% for the material. At the time of collecting additional assignment, students is obliged to explain the test orally to the assistant supervisor. 5. Additional tests apply to individuals. Students are required to make additional assignment if not wearing a skirt during the tutorial for female students and do not use collared clothes for male students. And the last is loss integrated assistant note. And that's all from Praktikum Department. Thank you!
Next, for the tools learning flows and tutorial information access will be explained by Maintenance Information and Technology Department. The flow of learning tool. First, please contact the DSK assistant, especially MIT department. The contact person of MIT department are following below. First, Rahmanur Hidayah with ID line Rahmanurhi. Second, Devoni Putri Rahajeng with ID line Devoni.ra. Third, Muhammad Dafa Prihartono with ID line MDafaP. Second, please fill out the form of learning tools by this link. And then, download the letter of agreement by this link. Next, ask for approval from the head of the DSKE laboratory. And then, please contact the DSKE laborant to pick up the tool. 6. Submit the identity card as guarantee to the DSKE. Next, the period of loaning is only in 7 days. If extending is needed, you have to refill the form. And the last, if you have finished using the tools, you have to return to the DSKE laboratory to get your identity card back. The flow of loaning book. First, you have to fill the form of loaning book, and then go to the DSKE laboratory. Next, submit the form and also identity card as guarantee to the DSKE. And then assistants will lend you the book. The period of loaning is only in 7 days. If extending is needed, you have to refill the form. If you have finished using the book, you have to return to the DSKE lab. And the last is you are gonna get your identity card back if returning correctly. The next explanation is about our social media. We have 3 social media accounts. Our main social media is Instagram. It used to share information about our lab activity, ergonomic, and practicum information with the name of its account is LabDSKE. Second, our social media is YouTube. The channel's name is Laboratorium Desain Sistem Kerja dan Ergonomi UII. We share videos about practicum and ergonomics. Also, we have Spotify account that shared podcasts about our laboratory and ergonomic topics with the lecturers.
Next, the introduction of the ergonomics and work system design laboratory assistant for the 2021-2022 period will be delivered by Human Capital Management Department.
Hello friends, me as a representative of HEM department would like to introduce the laboratory structure of work system design and ergonomic laboratory at the Islamic University of Indonesia. The first one is Ms. Atianti Diah Prabaswari, STMSC, as the head of the work system design and ergonomic laboratory. The second one is Mas Dwi Wahyu Santoso, SPD, as the laboratory laborant for work system design and ergonomic laboratory. Next, let's just get to know with the laboratory assistants for work system design and ergonomics laboratory. The first one is Mas Rifki Apriliansah as assistant coordinator with assistant code E140. In work system design and ergonomics laboratory, there are four departments, namely HEM department, RNK department, and the practicum department, and the last one is MIT department. The first from the HEM department is Ms. Zaidan with the assistant code E143 as the coordinator of the HEM department with three of his staff, namely Mbak Tania with the assistant code E137, Mbak Kamila with the assistant code E152, and myself with the assistant code E150. The second one from the RNK department is Mbak Alma with the assistant code E138. As the coordinator of RNK department with her four staff, namely Mbak Gisha with the assistant code of E144, Mbak Hersa with the E139 assistant code, Mas Anan with E146 assistant code, and the last one is Mbak Salma with assistant code E147. Then the third one is from the practicum department was Mbak Salva with the assistant code of E142 as a coordinator of the practicum department, along with her two staff, namely Mbak Alda with the assistant code of E148 and Mbak Fabiola with assistant code of E145. The last one from the MIT department was Mbak Rahma with the assistant code of E141 as the coordinator of MIT department, along with her two staff, namely Mas Dava with the assistant code of E149 and Mbak Devani with the E151 assistant code. And right now, let's get to know with our 8 new assistant in the Work System Design and Ergonomic Laboratory at the Islamic University of Indonesia. They are Ade Irawan Said, Nurdiana Sofi, Novanda Anggi Satrio Pangestu, Ardini Ramadhani Yusri, Tania Sepia Azahra Damanik, Ashifa Mutia Syafira, Tiara Febian, and the last one is Devina Inayah Iryani. Well, that's all friends, introduction from the Work System Design and Ergonomics Laboratory at the Islamic University of Indonesia.
The explanation about work system engineering and ergonomics tutorial has been explained entirely. Hopefully, it can be understood well. Please follow DSKE Laboratories Instagram on LabDSKE because all of the tutorial information will be announced on DSKE Laboratories Instagram. If you guys have a question about the explanation, you can drop your questions at DSKE Laboratories Instagram. Then for the question and answer session with your assistant will be held on pre-work system engineering and ergonomics tutorial briefing online on 20 March 2022. That's all. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.